सलमान हमिद फ्रॉम डेक्कन कॉलेज ऑफ मेडिकल साइंसेज हैदराबाद.
A very good afternoon. I am Hashmi and my topic of research and presentation is immunization coverage status and reasons for partial and non-immunization in urban slums of Hyderabad. My role in the survey was to collect data and help in the analysis of data. Let me start off with the Indian statistics. 60% of the Indian children with the age group 12 to 23 months in urban India, only 60% are immunized. Out of which 40% unimmunized children come from the import action group states, namely Rajasthan, Orissa, Assam, Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh. In these import action group states, the major reason for non-immunization was neglect in the urban slums. Only the immunization coverage reached only 1/3 of the urban slums. In a city like Hyderabad, where 26% of the city's population comes from urban slums and 12% of the land area is covered by urban slums, it is of great importance to cover the urban slums. There are greater chances of disease outbreaks in urban slums because of high population density and regular influx of immigrants, which may bring in infective agents. Secondly, we can prevent most of the disease outbreaks by giving vaccines and covering maximum children possible. So the aim of our study was to determine the immunization coverage status of urban slums of Hyderabad and to find out reasons for partial and non-immunization of children. Materials and method. The coverage evaluation study was done from January to mid-May 2014. It is a cross-sectional type of study, and the eligibility criteria of the children was they should have an age between 12 to 23 months, and they should have the parents should have lived in the area for more than 6 months. And the method follows the cluster method. WHO 30 cluster method was followed, in which 1,476 slums were divided into 58 geographical clusters, and 30 were selected based on probability to proportion size, according to which the greater the population of a cluster, the greater probability it has to get selected. Now, in the second phase, random sampling was done, and out of 3,840 households surveyed, 510 eligible children were taken. Now, coming to the definition of fully immunized, a child is declared as fully immunized if he takes BCG 0, OPV dose, not the OPV 0 dose, other than the OPV 0 dose, measles, and 3 DPT doses. And a child who has not received any vaccination till his first birthday, that is 12 months, he is declared as non-immunized. And the remaining, if they are taken, any one or more than one are included in partial immunized children. Pre-test for the selected eligible children, the parents or the guardians were given a pre-tested and a pre-structured questionnaire for collecting the socio-demographic data and reasons for default. The method used was vaccination card and recall method. In case of absence of both parents and mother and father, the grandparents or guardian were taken as the interviewers. The data was analyzed using SPSS software. Now coming to observation, out of the, according to our results, 44% are fully immunized, followed by 32 partially immunized and 24 non-immunized. And out of all the fully and partially immunized, only 47.2% of children had vaccination cards. And though immunization survey reached 76%, only 44 could be fully immunized. The most common reason for partial immunization and non-immunization was in availability of parents, either due to ill health, or most of them were daily wage workers, so they didn't want to lose their wage of the day by taking the child to the immunization center. And second reason was not present at the area when the immunization survey was there. Immunization were given, they were in the native villages. And third reason which topped the chart was Though they were residing in the area for more than 6 months, they did not know how to avail the services. The reasons followed were carelessness, sickness of the elder sibling after taking vaccination, and lack of effectiveness. And another thing which we found out was only out of all the subjects which we surveyed the parents, 36% of them knew only polio as a vaccination. These are the discussion. Now we have got specific reasons for partial and non-immunization. So rather than thinking on a common sense basis, we can go in for an evidence-based basis. For reasons like parent not coming to the immunization because he might miss a wage, we can provide incentives. We can arrange for means of transport. We can arrange for a token amount or at least meals, because meals at the immunization center, so that they don't starve that day. And second reason for carelessness, sickness of the elder sibling, and lack of effectiveness, lack of faith, the public health education can play a very important role in it. And taking example as polio, because 36% of them knew polio as the only vaccine to be taken, we can follow examples and take steps which were taken to eradicate polio. So rather than making people fully immunized needs a multi-pronged strategy. Thank you. We would like to thank the Department of Community Medicine and all the volunteers who were involved in collecting data, mainly the first year and second year students.
A good study.
Thank you.
But what is the 30 cluster sampling technique? How you have done?
Ma'am, first the 1,476 slums were divided into 58 geographical areas, ma'am. Then, based on the probability proportional size method, a sampling interval was taken by dividing the households by total number of clusters. Then, each cluster was picked by the sampling interval. So, in one cluster, more than one sample was taken, household was taken.
How many samples to be taken in a 30 cluster sampling technique from each cluster?
Ma'am, we did not follow 30:7 method of WHO, ma'am.
But you have mentioned that 30 cluster sampling technique being followed.
Yeah, ma'am, 30 cluster we have followed, ma'am. But in the second stage of 30 cluster, we took random houses, ma'am, and we followed till we get, because out of 3,840.
What is the till we get that number?
Yeah,
what do you mean by the till we get that number? What is the number required for from each cluster?
Out of 3,840, we got only 510 eligible children, ma'am. So we had to divide it equally in all the clusters.
Actually, that 30 cluster sampling technique, how many children to be covered, it is mentioned in that. First thing. The other one is, how many participants were there in your data collection and what type of training you have given to them to get that data? Who has given training to all those people who have collected the data? So how many people being participated in the data collection?
Ma'am, more than 200
so
students.
So what is the quality assurance related to the data collection?
They were actually, most of them, apart from them, health workers from our community health center, PSC, were there, ma'am. So they told them what
PSC
to ask.
PSC is there in Hyderabad?
Not PSC, ma'am. Bhavani Nagar, our center at Bhavani Nagar and Hassan
Nagar.
So
this Nagar, is a cluster, 30 cluster sampling technique distributed in entire Hyderabad, and then what are all the slums selected under the clusters and number of children selected from each of that. The other one is related with, have you inquired about the education level of the parents? You are talking about health education on one side. You have to link up the educational level of the mothers to the health care. What type of health education you have to follow? You are not mentioned regarding anything related to the education of the parents.
Ma'am, actually in social,
but actually you need to do all these things. I'm not criticizing anything.
Yeah.
But when you're presenting a data like immunization coverage evaluation, the 30 cluster sampling technique, you must be aware of all these things related with. Good study.
Thank you.
Good study.